While mold is a very common problem in homes and businesses all over the world, what may be very confusing to people are the tests that are used to determine mold infestation. For example, there is viable and non-viable testing. This in and of itself may sound confusing, so let me explain. Non-viable testing is taking samples on some sticky media or on a filter membrane or tape, and then directly examining the samples under a microscope for evaluation and identification. Viable testing takes samples on some growth media and then incubates the sample to germinate and form colonies. The colonies are then transferred to other media for identification. Non-viable sampling is generally used to determine how contaminated the air is, while viable sampling is used to determine if the air contains a specific species of mold. If you need to know both the level of contamination and the species, you would use both methods. Fortunately, the experts at MoldBusters use both methods and can assist you with any testing you need on your home or business. For more information about viable and non-viable testing methods, visit our website at www.busmold.com, and remember, it's not mold until it's tested.